Okay, I decided to invest in a good 3D fish finder so it can help me find fish and catch them. Today is shorter, especially in winter time, so it's very important to not fish blindly, but find the fish first and then catch them. And in winter time, the fish tend to be residing in the deeper water column area. So if you can't find them, it's just hard to cast to them and then catch them. So the two 3D fish finders that I did the research on are the Raymarine Axiom 3D fish finder and the Lowrance HDS 9 inches generation 3 fish finder. Both are 3Ds and both have the Navionics Plus maps for US lakes and rivers. So these two fish finders are the ones I'm going to be sharing with you. Price-wise, Raymarine is cheaper because Raymarine's doesn't have this black box to process the whatever image sonar image that these two transducer are getting, and so it's cheaper because the price for the black box and the Lowrance structure scan 3D processor and this transducer is almost $1,000, and the Raymarine 3D is about $1,600, $1,650, and this display for Lowrance is about another $900. So $900, so it's you're looking at about $1,900, $2,000 just for Lowrance. The Raymarine is about $1,600, so it's $1,650, so it's a little bit cheaper. And now I'm gonna run down the all the features. Both are touch screen, by the way, as you can see here. And the transducer for Raymarine is called RV100. It's a force channel sonar, meaning it has the chirp sonar, it has the down vision sonar, it has the side vision sonar, or it has the real vision 3D capability. All four, instead of having four transducers, it's all combined into one single transducer. Same thing as Lowrance 3D transducer. It has a 3D processing box, and it has a structure scan 3D transducer that can do the chirp and side vision, down vision, and the 3D views. And the next feature, Lowrance has this what's called a track back history view, which basically Lowrance unit can record the sonar images as you scan the river or the lake as you drive the boat around. But I don't believe the Raymarine has the capability of recording the sonar images. It may have the capability of recording, but you cannot track back. You cannot go back in history, other than the waypoints. I think the waypoints you can go back, but that's more saved instead of going back frame by frame. That's what I meant. Sonar images going back. That's track back history. It's a an advantage on the Lowrance unit. That's why it's more expensive. But anyway, the next feature is the depth. The Raymarine claim it can the chirp sonar can detect from 2 feet, it's 900 feet of water. The Lowrance is only up to 300 feet, and the down vision is 600 feet on the Raymarine, and side vision is 300, and the 3D is 300. And for that, Raymarine. Sorry, the Lowrance has the 300 feet deep and 300 feet to either side, and 300 feet for the 3D. Lowrance didn't specify the chirp sonar, whether it's going down to 900 or even further or deeper. And the down vision, they didn't say. They just say, you know, the 3D is 300 feet deep, and the 300 feet to either side, meaning combined 600 feet to the side of boats, you know, on both sides. And same thing with Raymarine. I think same thing with Raymarine. So the Raymarine side scan 300 feet is really just for either side. I'm still waiting for Raymarine to confirm. The dimension is about 10 by 6 by 3 inches. Lowrance unit is 10 by 6 by 3, just a little bit bigger. The resolution for both displays are 800 by 480. It's the same as the 7 inches machine. The frequencies of the sonar, Lowrance disclosed a lot more than the Raymarine. As you can see here, you know, has the chirp sonar ranges and the narrow wide beam ranges and the 3D sonar ranges instead of just the 5200 kilohertz that the Raymarine disclosed. The receiver for GPS is 10 hertz, 72 channel for Raymarine, but Lowrance only stated 70 channels. And the connection interface, both have Wi-Fi, both have Bluetooth, and they both use their own apps. And in data network, both have the Ethernet port, so you can connect using the Ethernet cable, or Raymarine called that RayNet. And Raymarine also claim that theirs have can access to USB using USB. It has a USB port when you purchase another accessory. But what is it? Lowrance doesn't specify that. Both are capable or compatible to NEMA 2000 network and the NEMA 0183 network, but you need to buy an adapter. Transmit power for Raymarine is a little bit higher, stronger, 600 watts and versus 500 watts. The bigger the watts, the deeper the sonar can detect of water. And the memory is for Raymarine is only one slot, but the Lowrance has two slots. I suppose one is for the recording memory card. Both are compatible with radar and the VHF and autopilot, and warranty is 2 years, 3 years versus for Raymarine versus 2 years for Lowrance. I don't know whether Lowrance has offered to 3 years when you register. I'm imagining they probably have the similar competitive warranty on their fish finder. Okay. Please subscribe as I have my Raymarine Axiom 9 with 3D sonar in shipment, and I will be able to show you more amazing sonar, 3D sonar images soon, and I'll share with you my tips of using them. Take care.